हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम टू क्रिएट अप। आई एम विकास भदौरिया एंड आई वेलकम बैक। आई एम बैक अगेन विद अनदर लेक्चर इन थर्मोडायनेमिक्स एंड टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू स्टार्ट फर्स्ट लॉ ऑफ थर्मोडायनेमिक्स। सो इन द प्रीवियस लेक्चर आई हैव कवर्ड नॉन फ्लो वर्क एंड दैट वाज इन द प्रीवियस वीक एंड दिस वीक वी आर गोइंग टू कवर सम इम्पॉर्टेंट लेक्चर्स इन थर्मोडायनेमिक्स। सो टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू स्टार्ट विद फर्स्ट लॉ ऑफ थर्मोडायनेमिक्स। फर्स्ट लॉ ऑफ थर्मोडायनेमिक्स इज वन ऑफ द इम्पॉर्टेंट लॉ ऑफ थर्मोडायनेमिक्स। First law of thermodynamics. This is the very important law of thermodynamics, and you all have studied about this law in your 10th, 12th, and in your elementary classes. That law of conservation of energy is another name of first law of thermodynamics. So what it says is that energy can neither be created nor be destroyed, it can only be transferred from one form to another. Okay, so energy can neither be created nor be destroyed and transferred from one form to another. There are different examples of first law of thermodynamics. For example, if you see your tube light, in your tube light the electrical energy also a kind of energy, right? So it is getting converted into light energy. Okay, this is very important application. Other application is, for example, in your boilers or in your compressor. In the compressor, the electrical energy in the form of motor is getting converted into mechanical energy due to work of compression. Okay, so there are different examples of, like in turbine, the mechanical energy at the shaft of the turbine is getting converted into electrical energy with the help of generator. Okay, so energy is getting transferred from one form to another, and practical example of first law of thermodynamics are plenty in number. Okay, so you all have studied about these examples of first law of thermodynamics and also about this definition that energy is conserved. Okay, this is already you all know that energy is conserved, or energy of the total system is conserved, or energy is always transferred from one form to another. It is neither created nor destroyed. But if we talk about the engineering thermodynamics, when we move to the graduation level, the definition of first law of thermodynamics becomes changed. It actually does not change, it remains same. Okay, but this statement wise definition of first law of thermodynamics changes into some another definitions. So in the lecture of basics of thermodynamics, we have studied about closed system and open system. Now first law of thermodynamics, quantitative definition of first law of thermodynamics for closed system and open system is different. It actually satisfied this energy is conserved, but it is represented by some mathematical equations. Now what are those mathematical equations? Let us see that. So in this first law of thermodynamics, if we apply this first law of thermodynamics for a closed system undergoing a cycle, do focus on this word cycle, closed system undergoing a cycle, the net heat interaction, summation of all the heat which are going, or which heat interaction which are taking place in that cycle, is equal to summation of all the work interaction taking place for that cycle. So this is called first law of thermodynamics for a closed system undergoing a cycle, which is going through a cycle. Okay, so if you compare that from the definition type of first law of thermodynamics, that energy is conserved. Yes, energy is conserved. Total heat energy interaction for a cycle are equal to total work energy interaction. Okay, so this is called the quantitative definition of first law of thermodynamics for a closed system undergoing cycle. So if you see that there is a closed system which is undergoing a different cycles. Suppose the cycle is 1, 2, 1A2, 2B1 or 2C1. Okay. Now all the heat interaction from Q12 or Q21 will be equal to all the work interaction taking place for this 1A2 and 2B1 cycle. So we can say that heat interaction from Q1A2 plus Q2B1, that is the total heat interaction for this cycle, 1A2 and 2B1, this is the cycle. Okay, I have already told you about this, what is the process and cycle, what is the difference between a process and cycle. So 1A2 is a process, 2B1 is a process, but if the system is returning back from its initial point following a path, then it executes a cycle. So for this cycle 1A2 2B1, we can say that the total heat interaction according to this first law of thermodynamics, total heat interaction will be Q1A2 along this path, Q2B1 will be equal to W1A2 plus W2B1. Okay, and do remember we have to put this delta sign before heat and work. What is the significance of putting this delta? Delta stands for that heat and work are inexact differential. For inexact differential, we use this delta before all the quantities which are inexact differential. So since heat and work both are inexact differential, we will put this delta here. Okay. So this is the cumulative first law of thermodynamics for a closed cycle, and this is how we will represent it. Okay. So all the heat interaction which is taking place will be equal to all the work interaction for a cycle. Okay. Now you have to remember this, and this is very important for calculation also. Okay. Some question or numerical can come from this first law of thermodynamics. So this is very, very important. Okay. Now to apply this first law of thermodynamics, there are some sign convention also. Okay. So what are the sign convention? See, if you talk about the sign convention for the numerical of first law of thermodynamics, we have to use some sign convention. What are the sign convention? Because if we don't follow the sign convention, Okay. Now suppose there is a system and some heat is coming to the system Q1. Q2 is heat is leaving the system Q2. W1 work is given to the system and W2 work is done by the system. Okay. So sign convention for work you have already studied in the lecture of non-flow work. I hope you remember that. Okay. But if you talk about sign convention for heat, that you will definitely study in the next lecture of heat, that is tomorrow. And in the sign convention of heat, if the heat is supplied to the system, heat is given to the system, then heat is equal to, it is a positive quantity. Heat supplied to the system is a positive quantity. Heat taken away, heat rejected to the surrounding, or heat which is taken out from the system is a negative quantity. Heat rejected is always a negative quantity. Heat supplied is a positive quantity. Okay. So the example is condenser. In the condenser, in the steam power plant, in the Rankine cycle, if you remember, the condenser heat rejection takes place. So heat rejection is a negative. Similarly, in the boiler, we supply heat in the boiler. So that is a positive. That will be a positive heat interaction. In the condenser, it will be a negative heat interaction. Okay. Now, what about the work? When W1 is a work which is done on the system. Work done on a system is a negative work. Work done on system is a negative work. Work done by the system is a positive work. Example, expansion work. Expansion work is always a work done by the system. Example, in turbine, we do work by expansion. It is a positive quantity. So, turbine work is always a positive work. So, I am going to write the example also. It is turbine negative work. Work done on the system. Work done on the system is a negative work. Example, compressor. In the compressor, work is done on the system. Okay, so example is compressor. Heat supplied to the system, example is boiler. And here the example is condenser. Okay. So I am writing the examples also. Okay. So you have to remember this sign convention when you are dealing with problems of first law of thermodynamics. They will be very, very much useful to give you those 1 marks for numericals. Because for numericals in first law of thermodynamics, you have to be careful about the sign convention. So that's why I have taken that pause from first law of thermodynamics definition, and I have explained you the sign convention because these are very, very important. Okay. So while solving the numerical, you have to be take care of this sign convention. Now again, come back to the definition of first law of thermodynamics. The quantitative definition of first law of thermodynamics is, for a closed system undergoing a cycle, net heat interaction is equal to net work interaction. Okay. So, if a cycle is given, you have to follow that first law of thermodynamics. Now, there are some consequences. This first law of thermodynamics gave some consequences also. What are the consequences or consequences of first law of thermodynamics? First consequence or outcomes. First is, heat transfer is a path function. It is a path function. Well, in the lecture of non-flow work, I have told you about work is a path function. Okay, because it does not depend on the initial fine points. It only depends on the path followed by the system from moving from one state to another. Similarly, heat transfer is also a path function which is given by first law of thermodynamics. And let us see that how it is a path function. Suppose it is a PV diagram. System is undergoing a cycle from 1A2 and 2B1. This is a first cycle. Another cycle 1A2, 2C1. Okay, and it is a reversible cycle. Okay. So if we apply this first law of thermodynamics for 1A2 and 2B1, we have just seen what is first law of thermodynamics for a cycle. Net heat interaction is equal to net work interaction. So for cycle 1A2, 2B1, the first law of thermodynamics for a cycle will be Q1A2 plus Q2B1 will be equal to W1A2 plus W2B1. So I am just omitting this delta should be there because work is up and heat are path function, and in exact differential you have to put this delta. So if you rearrange here for 1A, this is for 1A2B1. For 1A2C1 cycle, for this cycle 1A2 and 2C1, another cycle, the first law of thermodynamics will be del Q of 1A2 plus del Q of 2C1 will be equal to del Q of, sorry, 1A2 plus of 2C1. Okay. Now we got two equations. This is the first equation. This is the second equation. from these three equations, what you will get, if you just subtract from one second from the first, you will get, this thing will get cancelled out. So you will be left with del q of 2b1 minus del q of 2c1 will be equal to del w of 2b1 minus del w of 2c1. Okay? So, we got this statement after applying this, after subtracting second from the first. So, this quantity, del w 2b1 minus del w 2c1 will not be equal to 0. Why it will not be equal to 0? Because work transfer is a path function. So, these two quantities will not be equal. Although the initial final points are same, but path B and C are different. So, path B and C are different. So, this quantity will not be equal to 0. If this is not equal to 0, then this quantity will also not be equal to 0. Okay, that is, this will not be equal to 0. What is the meaning of this? Meaning of this is that heat transfer, though initial and final points are same, but path are different, so heat transfer is a path function. Okay, heat transfer is also a path function like work transfer. Okay. Now taking from this point only, I'm going to tell you what is first law of thermodynamics for a process. So if you take this from here, del Q 2B1 minus del Q 2C1 is equal to del W of 2B1 minus del W of 2C1, that is what you got by subtracting equation 1 from 2. If you rearrange 2B1 terms to get here, one side and 2C1 other side, so you will get, in the LHS you will get del Q 2B1 minus del W 2B1 will be equal to del Q 2C1 minus del W 2C1. Right? Now, if you take this as common, you will get del Q of, this is common. Here, in the right hand side, this is common, and in the left hand side, this is common. So, you will get del Q minus del W of 2B1 is equal to del Q minus del W of 2C1. Right? Now, this quantity, Q minus W, del Q minus del W, both the side in the LHS and RHS is same. This quantity is same. This is del Q minus del W. Also, the initial and final points are same. Only the path are different. So, such a quantity must be a change in property. And this change in property is equal to del Q minus del W is equal to dE. This is known as energy. Okay? So, since this and initial final points are same and the quantity is also same, only the path are different, such a quantity can only be a property, and this property is known as energy. So, del Q minus del W is equal to dE, that we got from here, and if you rearrange, you will get del Q is equal to del W plus dE. This is called as first law for a process. First law of thermodynamics for process. Now, this process can be a reversible process as well as a irreversible process. So, this is the first law of thermodynamics for a process, and that net heat interaction is equal to net work interaction is the first law of thermodynamics for a cycle. That can be a reversible cycle as well as irreversible cycle. Okay. So, if you take it from here, this is the first law of thermodynamics for a process, and this is very, very important. del Q is equal to del W plus DE. Now, this energy in terms of first law of thermodynamics is sum of kinetic energy, potential energy and internal energy. Okay? This energy is a sum of kinetic energy, potential energy and internal energy U. So, DE will be sum of del E plus DU. If the kinetic energy and potential energy change are not there, if there is no kinetic energy and potential energy change, if these are negligible, so this first law of thermodynamics reduces to del Q is equal to del W plus DU. With the assumptions that the assumptions are changes in kinetic energy and potential energy are zero. If they are given as zero, then the first law of thermodynamics will reduce from this equation to this equation. Okay, so there are some assumptions also. If you talk about first law, there are some assumptions. So, if you have to apply this equation, the assumptions are kinetic energy, potential energy change are zero. If you have to apply this equation, this is a generalized equation. Generalized first law for process. And this is based on the assumption that kinetic energy change and potential energy change is equal to zero. Okay. Now, this work, since we are studying first law of thermodynamics for a closed system. So, for a closed system undergoing a reversible process or this non-flow work, the work is equal to non-flow work or boundary work. And the non-flow boundary work we have studied in the previous week in the lecture of non-flow work, that this work is equal to PdV work. For a closed system, non-flow work is equal to PdV work. Now, if you apply this assumption, you will get del Q is equal to PdV plus DU. Okay? So, this is another equation of first law thermodynamics for a process based on another assumption that it is a closed system, quasi-static and boundary work. Okay? So, you will get this equation. Okay? So, for today, you got these important equation in first law of thermodynamics, and these are very, very important, and you should never forget it, because in the quantitative definition of first law of thermodynamics, the equations are very, very important. Okay? And these are for process, and for the cycle, the first law is del Q is equal to net heat interaction is equal to net work interaction for a cycle. Okay, so these are some important equations from first law of thermodynamics. Okay, so far we have got to know about the equation of first law of thermodynamics for a cycle in process and one important consequence of first law of thermodynamics, which is heat transfer is a path function. Now, there are some other consequences also. What are those? Another consequence of first law of thermodynamics is that energy of an isolated system is constant. Energy of an isolated system is constant. Well, we have studied about the isolated system in the lecture of basics of thermodynamics, that isolated system is a system in which no energy and mass interaction take place. So, if no energy and mass interaction are taking place, so heat transfer is equal to zero and work is also equal to zero, right? Because energy interaction will be in the form of heat, work or any other energy. Now, if we apply the first law of thermodynamics, it is del Q is equal to del W plus DE. Now, since it is an isolated system, for an isolated system, energy interaction in the form of heat and work are zero for isolated system. There will be no energy interaction. So, these two quantities will be zero. So, if these two quantities are zero, So you will get change in energy is equal to zero. Right? Now if this change in energy is equal to zero, any change in difference, any quantity is equal to zero, that means that quantity must be constant. So that means energy is a constant quantity for a isolated system. For an isolated system, energy is always constant. Okay? And this is very, very important. For an isolated system, energy is constant. That is the consequence of first law of thermodynamics. Okay? So I hope you will remember it. This is very, very important. Okay? Now, another consequence of first law of thermodynamics is perpetual motion machine. Motion machine of first kind is not possible. Okay? Perpetual motion machine of first kind is not possible. Okay? Now, what is the meaning of this? What is perpetual motion machine? Which is another name of perpetual motion machine is PMM1. That is perpetual motion machine 1 or first kind is not possible. What is the meaning of first kind? First kind means related to first law of thermodynamics. So, what is this PMM1? So, when any law is invented by some scientists, what does people do? People try to find some way to so that we this law can be neglected, okay? Or some try to prove the law, some try to apply those law in terms of some machine, okay? So, like Carnot cycle, some try to invent all the engines are based on Carnot cycle, okay? So, the Carnot cycle is a standard cycle, although there is no such engine which is based on Carnot cycle, but engines actually are the basics of all the engines is Carnot cycle. So, very similar to that, when a law is invented, people try to make machine which is based on some law. PMM1 is the opposite of this thing. PMM1 is a hypothetical machine which don't follow first law of thermodynamics, okay? So, PMM1 is a hypothetical machine. Why hypothetical? Because it is not possible. It is totally imaginary. It is not possible. Anything which is not possible is called hypothetical. Okay. So, a hypothetical machine which violate first law of thermodynamics. So, a hypothetical machine which violates first law of thermodynamics is called PMM1. Okay. Now, why does and how does it violate the first law of thermodynamics? See, first law of thermodynamics says that energy is neither created nor be destroyed. It is always transferred from one form to another. That means if you want to get something, you have to give something. Simple meaning. So if you want to purchase any item, you have to go to the market, give some money and you can buy it. But can you get anything for free? Especially in today's world? No, you cannot. You go to a shop, you just ask for something and if you don't have money, they will not give you. Okay. So, but PMM1 says that you can take something from a device without supplying anything as input. So, that's why it is called a hypothetical machine. Now, if we talk it in terms of thermodynamics, PMM1 says that it is a device from which you can continuously extract work. You are taking out work from this device continuously without supplying energy in the form of heat or any other form of energy. You are not supplying, you are not giving any energy, no energy supplied as input, but work is produced continuously. Is it possible? Can you find any device from which you can continuously extract the energy without any energy input? No, you cannot. So that's why this PMM-1 is actually violation of first law of thermodynamics, because first law of thermodynamics says that energy is always transferred from one form to another such that total energy of the system will remain conserved. So if you take any example, if you want to run an engine, you have to supply some fuel to run the engine. If you want to extract steam from the boiler, you have to supply heat from the furnace. If you want to convert this, if you want to produce power from the turbine, you have to supply mechanical energy in the form of steam from the boiler to the turbine, so that shaft of the turbine can rotate and it can rotate the shaft of the generator and electricity can be produced. So this PMM-1 is actually violating all the devices which are based on first law of thermodynamics. So it is a hypothetical device which is violating first law of thermodynamics, and it says that you cannot make a machine which continuously provide you work without supplying some energy as input. Now this energy can be either heat energy or kinetic energy or potential energy or electrical energy. It should be some input energy to get something as output. Okay. And in terms of simply to understand, you cannot get anything for free. You have to pay to get something, right? So this is PMM-1, and this violates first law of thermodynamics. So the question can come in the exam: PMM-1 violates which law of thermodynamics? Second law, first law, zeroth law, or third law of thermodynamics? It violates first law of thermodynamics. Okay? So this is very, very important. So first law of thermodynamics for a closed system, very small lecture, but that is small, but that doesn't mean it is not important. Sometimes small things are very, very important. So this was, although the lecture was not quite big, but it is very, very important whatever we have studied in this class. Okay. So tomorrow lecture, we are going to study the topic of heat and what is heat interaction in different thermodynamic process. So you must be thinking that in thermodynamics also, is heat that much important? Yes, heat is very, very important. Heat is so much important that there is a separate subject of heat transfer that you have to study in mechanical engineering. Okay. So in tomorrow lecture, we are going to study the topic of heat. What are different heat interactions for different thermodynamic process? And then after that, you will study steady flow energy equation, which is first law of thermodynamics for an open system. But before we end this class, let us solve some questions based on first law of thermodynamics. Now, since this is a recorded class, but I will definitely solve these questions so that you can apply the concept that you have studied today in this class and you can understand how you can apply this concept. Okay. So this is the first question. In this question, it is given that a system executed a cyclic process during which there are two processes, which are given as Q12 is given as 460 kilojoule, Q221 is given as -100 kilojoule, and W122 is given as 210 kilojoule. You have to find out what will be the work interaction in the form of W221. So what is given? What is given quantity here? Q122 is given. That is Q, heat transfer from state 1 to state 2 is given, which is equal to 460 kilojoule. What else is given? Q221 is also given to you. This is equal to -100 kilojoule. Okay. Also, what is given to you? W122 is given to you, which is equal to 210 kilojoule. What is to be found? W221. This is to be found. How we can find it? So, whenever you see a problem in the exam, just think, this problem is from which topic? This problem is, here it is saying a system execute a cyclic process. Here it is a cyclic process. Complete cycle is given. Okay. And there are two processes. One from 1 to 2, other from 2 to 1. So, process is taking place from 1 to 2 and back from 2 to 1. So, it is a cycle, not a process. Because when system is returning back to the initial state, it is a cycle. Now, for a cycle, first law of thermodynamics is, what is first law for a cycle? First law for a cycle is, net heat interaction is equal to net work interaction. You have to apply this law of thermodynamics. First law of thermodynamics for a cycle. Now, according to this law, Q12 plus Q21 will be equal to W122 plus W221. So, Q122 is given to you 460. Q221 is also given to you minus 100. W122 is given to you 210. You have to find W221. So, you will get, you have to just put these values, 460 minus 100 is equal to W122 is 210 plus W221. So, from here you will get, this is as 350 is equal to 210 plus W221. Simple mathematics, you will get 140. What you will get from here? Sorry, this is 360, not, this is 360. So, you will get from here that W221 you will get as 150 kilojoule. Okay? You will get W221 as 150 kilojoule. Okay. So, this is how we have applied the, whatever we have studied today, we have applied this in this form of numerical. Okay. Next question. First law of thermodynamics furnishes the relationship between heat and work, heat work and properties of the system, various property of the system, and none of these. Okay, so it is talking about first law of thermodynamics. And when it is not mentioning whether it is a cycle and process, you have to take it as a process, not for a cycle. So for a process, the first law is del Q is equal to del W plus DE. Now, it is saying first law of thermodynamics furnishes means establish relationship between heat and work only, or heat, work and property of the system, various property of system, or none of these. So, only property will not be the answer, because property, heat and work are not the property, because properties are point function, heat and work are not point function, they are path function. Okay, so third statement is wrong. And if we talk about the first statement, only heat and work, as I have told you, if not mention that which law, first law of thermodynamics is whether for a cycle or for a process, by default you have to take it for a process. Okay, so for a process, first law is del Q is equal to del W plus D. So it establishes the relationship between heat, work and E, change in energy. Energy is a property. And property is a path function. Sorry, point function. Why it is called a point function? Because the properties depend only on the initial and final points and not on the path followed by the process. That means if we are finding change in energy from 1 to 2, it will be simply E2 minus E1. But you cannot say change in heat transfer from 1 to 2 is equal to Q2 minus Q1. This will not be there. Why it is not there? Because heat transfer is not a property. It is a path function. But energy is a property, so you can write it like this. That is very, very important thing. Okay? Same applies to work. Work is also a path function, not a property. So you cannot write W122 as W2 minus W1, but you can write this as like this. So the answer will be option number B, heat, work and property. So in the exam, if not mentioned whether you have to apply first law of thermodynamics for a process or for a cycle, you have to take it as for a process. Okay. Next question, perpetual motion machine of the first kind violates first law of thermodynamics, second, both or none of these. So this we have already discussed in today's lecture. First law, PMM1 violates first law of thermodynamics. Okay. So option number A will be the answer. Next question. If 300 kilojoule per kg heat is added to the system and work done on the system is 6000 kilojoule per kg, then you have to find change in internal energy of the system. Okay. Now to solve this question, you have to use which equation of first law of thermodynamics, for a cycle or for a process? Since here it is given, heat and work are given and internal energy is to be found, you have to use first law for a process. Okay. And that too, this law. You have to use this equation. Okay. Now in this equation, what is given to you? Heat is added. You have to use sign convention also. What are the sign convention? Heat is added to the system. Heat added to a system is a positive quantity. I have told you in this today's lecture only that heat added to the system is a positive quantity. So this will be plus 3000 kilojoule per kg. And it is saying work is done on the system. Work done on the system is a negative work. Okay. So this will be minus 6000 kilojoule per kg plus change in internal energy. Simple calculation, du will be equal to plus 9000 kilojoule per kg. Okay. So the right answer will be option number A, but you have to remember the sign convention and you have to use the sign convention, because if you don't use the sign convention, simply put the value of heat and work and don't follow the sign convention, you will get the wrong answer, right? If you put simply this as plus 6000, then you will get du as minus 3000. It will be a wrong answer if you don't follow the sign convention, and you will get the wrong answer. You will get option number C, but the right answer is option number A, because you have to use the sign convention. Okay, so that's why for first law of thermodynamics, sign convention are very, very important. If you do a wrong sign convention, if you don't follow the sign convention, you will land on to the wrong answer. Okay, so that's why sign convention are very, very important. If you don't follow sign convention, you will get a negative marking in the exam. So do follow the sign convention. Heat entered to the system is a, or supplied to the system is a positive. Heat rejected is a negative quantity. Work done on the system is a negative quantity. Work done by the system is a positive quantity. Sorry. Okay. So with the help of these two numericals, you must have understood how we can apply this. The concept that are studied in the first law of thermodynamics are very, very important. Okay. Next question. Consider the below diagram of heat transfer and work transfer of a system. What will be the first law equation for the below system? So this diagram must not be clear to you. So I'm going to draw this diagram again. Okay. So the diagram is like this. There is a system. And in this system, some heat and work interaction are taking place. So Q1 heat is supplied to the system. And W1 work is done on the system. Q2 heat is rejected from the system. And W2 and W3 work are done by the system. Okay. Now you have to write first law equation for this system. How you can write it? You have to follow the sign convention. So sign convention are very important. Like I told you, heat entered to the system. Heat entered to the system will be positive. So Q1 will be a positive quantity. Then Q2 is heat rejected. So it will be minus Q2. Okay. You have easily got the LHS side, left hand side. What about the right hand side? Right hand side is work. Now work is W2 and W3 work are done by the system, and W1 work is done on the system. Work done on the system is a negative quantity. Work done by the system is a positive quantity. So it will be W2 plus W3 minus W1. Okay. Now, since in this equation, energy is also given to you. Okay. Because it is asking about first law for a process, not for a cycle. So you have to add energy also, del E. Because if you apply the first law for a process, it is del Q is equal to del W plus DE. It is plus DE. Okay. So you have found the value of del Q and del W for the process. You have to just add the value of delta E and you will get the first law for this system. So what will be the answer? Q1 minus Q2 is equal to del E plus W2 plus W3 minus W1. So option number C will be the answer. You can see there is a confusion between option A and option C. They are trying to confuse. So the answer will be option number C, not option number A. So option number C will be the answer. Okay. So this was a very good question based on the application of both first law of thermodynamics and also the sign convention. Last question. For an isolated system, energy change is equal to zero, heat transfer zero, work is zero, or all of these. Well, for an isolated system, we know that energy interaction is already zero. There is no energy interaction. So option B and C are correct. And we have just seen the consequence of first law of thermodynamics in today's lecture, that energy of an isolated system is constant. So D is equal to zero. So all the three statements are correct. The right answer will be option number D. Okay. So today in this lecture, we have not only studied what is first law of thermodynamics, quantitative definition of first law of thermodynamics, but also we have seen different equation for first law, for a cycle and for a process, with some assumption, without some assumptions. And we have also seen some sign convention that are followed to solve the numericals of first law of thermodynamics. And also in the end, we have solved some numericals. So I hope this lecture was useful to you. Okay. And so this is all for the day. I will meet you in the next lecture of heat. Heat is a very important topic from first law of thermodynamics also, because there is a separate subject of heat transfer that you have to study, in which you will study modes of heat transfer, conduction, convection and radiation. But if we only limit the heat transfer in this thermodynamic subject, here you have to study heat interaction in different thermodynamic process. There are formula for heat interaction for different thermodynamic process, and that is also very important, and that will be studied in tomorrow lecture in the YouTube series of Mechanical RBSSC JEE course. Okay. So I will meet you in the next lecture. Till then, prep smart, score better with Grade Up. Thank you and have a good day. Thank you.